Well, hello. Welcome to day 4 of Inktober. Today I'm going to be drawing the pattern Souk by Steph Kiefhaber CZT. And this one's quite fun, though I have to admit before we get going that I kind of went a little bit overboard with this pattern. So it starts off with a series of curves. And then overlapping these, you'll draw curves in the opposite direction, creating these lovely little diamond shapes as the points overlap. I'll go ahead and finish this little guy off. And then I think I'm going to embellish what I have here before I go ahead and draw the rest of the pattern. So for each of these diamond shapes, I'm going to leave a little bit of a shine on that top edge, but otherwise ink them all the way in. Then I'm going to add some little flicks to the ends of these seed shapes. Make it look like it's almost like a ribbon that's been gathered at the edges. So for the next step of the pattern, on top of these diamond shapes, we're going to put sort of these curvy point shapes. And you'll go every other one along one edge, and then I'll switch to the opposite side and draw these curvy point shapes on the remaining diamond shapes. And here's where I completely deviated from the actual pattern and just started playing around. So I extended these curvy shapes from the tip of their point to one of the corners of an adjacent diamond shape. I know that sounds a little strange, but I hope you can see what I mean on the video. And then I put two more lines inside, trying to almost break that little ribbon or that little seed shape into thirds. And I did this all along one edge, and then I go back and do the same thing along the opposite side. I like this. I'm going to go ahead and I think ink in the outer stripes here. So this one, and then this one right here. And for each one of these, you know, series of three curvy shapes, I'll ink in the outer edge and the inner stripe. I quite like all that inking in and drama. Now I'm going to go ahead and add in an aura all along each side of this ribbon shape. Now I quite like how this pattern looks just as it is before I shade it, but on the other hand, I feel like I want to add something new. I'm not quite sure what. Let me give it a minute. You know, I think I want to add some orbs where there are those little points left over on the diamonds. Let me show you right here. I think I'll go ahead and add some auras as if this were a crescent moon shape. And on that third aura, I think I just want to do three. I think I'll go ahead and add some weight where the line touches that outer aura. Yeah, just like that. I'll add this in every space where there's those little extra points for the diamond shapes sticking out. All right, I'm satisfied with the drawing, so I'm going to switch over to my pencil and start with my shading. I'll add a little bit of graphite to each end of the seed shapes and to each side along that white stripe. And then I think I'll add some graphite right here inside this like original pointy shape. And right here along the side of the diamond shape. Yeah, let's continue on that pattern all the way down the ribbon. I'm also going to add some graphite where those crescent moon shapes tuck behind the outer aura of the ribbon. And then, of course, I want to add graphite all along the outer edge of this shape. We've got all our graphite on. Now let's go ahead and smooth it all out with our tortillion. As a last bit of embellishment, I'm going to take a white jelly roll and add some shine to these black stripe shapes, especially where I see a little bit of a curve on the stripe. Yeah, admittedly, I went a little overboard with this pattern and deviated from the original pattern, but I quite like how it turned out. Thank you so much for joining me on another day, another adventure in Inktober, and I hope to see you again tomorrow. Have a great rest of your day. Bye-bye.